Hey there folks, Crosslux here with more Let's Play Cookie Run Oven Break. In the last episode, we began our arduous task of conquering the Island of Memories, specifically Hero Cookies. Today we're going to be taking a short break and doubling back to the spiritual successor to this Island of Memories, the Cookie Trials. Previously I've only covered 1 to 2 Cookie Trials per video, but I was doing live commentary for those sorts of videos. To keep the pace of the video higher, I decided to do everything post-commentary today, so please let me know how you guys feel about the change in the comments below. Anyways, up first we have Indiana Jones Cookie, Adventure Cookie. This cookie has traveled far and wide, beyond the realm of the witch. All other cookies thought he was a legend, but he's back, and will guide others to uncharted territories of a new and exciting world. His thirst for the unknown is unquenchable, and will continue to roam the wide world as long as he can. Now, I know the game constantly mentions that Ginger Brave is the bravest cookie, but based on the description of Adventurer here, I'd argue he's more brave. Regardless, his ability's pretty fun. Swinging through ropes really makes you feel like Batman. An adventurer. It only gets better the faster you go. The trick in order to do this is to make sure that you collide with the bottom of the hitbox. See, as you can see, I'm getting really long rope swings because I'm just barely colliding with those rope jellies. But if I were to do a double jump or jump higher up into it so that the distance between Adventurer and the hookshot location is shorter, then yeah, you'll get a shorter rope, which means slower swing speed and less jellies to be collected. But I suppose I could talk about his pet as well. It's a backpack, so it's something you easily overlook an adventurer to have, but it's actually really important. Like, I know for example, whenever I play Dungeons & Dragons with people, usually for the sake of gameplay, we kind of hand wave inventory space and, you know, how our characters are actually holding all the gear that we have, our torches, our food supplies, our sleeping bags, all that kind of stuff, but you know, if you're going for a more realistic game, then yeah, you probably need to acknowledge how you're carrying all that stuff. And so, Backpacky here, Adventurer Cookie's pet, seems to be a bag of holding of sorts. It holds a lot more than it looks like it should be able to, and it also seems to double as a sleeping bag. So, in terms of gameplay, he's really nice. He grants Adventurer Cookie a lot of extra energy, which makes sense, and deposits rations. And these rations have all sorts of equipment that Adventurer had packed right before he ran, I suppose. He packed in giant jellies, blast jellies, magnetic jellies. Anything you think you would need on the road, he's got in there. As for the treasures, I decided to go for a theme, like I usually do whenever I make videos for Cookie Run. I've given him the ticking treasure chest, the ancient treasure map, and the fabled magic carpet. I feel like all three of those are something that Adventurer Cookie would be using to get to where he needs to go. Up next is Blackberry Cookie. She always wears a reserved look, but it would be hard to find a more caring and devoted cookie. She's been working at one prestigious household for a very long time, and is praised for her miraculous ability to do a multitude of tasks in virtually no time. Despite Blackberry's tightest schedule, she always finds the time to save the life of her venturous employer. Perhaps this is her main duty these days. I'm sure you can all piece together that Adventurer is Blackberry's employer. The game never outright states this as a fact, but it's pretty heavily implied. This is why I've decided to do these two trials back to back. I also really like the design for Blackberry. She's very classy and macabre. Blackberry has a surprising amount of longevity since her ability spawns health potions every so often. Ghost Butler, otherwise known as Bootler, to me, and now by you, is one of my favorite pets, just because he's both cool and cute. We can see that Bootler here is probably the reason why Blackberry is so proficient at her job. I mean, her description says she seems to be in multiple locations at once in order to accomplish all of her tasks. Well, it looks like Bootler is in charge of commanding possibly a whole team of ghost butlers. So yeah, she probably has a lot of supernatural help to get her job done. But she's got a lot on her plate, so it only makes sense. I know I made a quick joke earlier, but honestly, I really do feel the Batman vibes between both Adventurer and Blackberry Cookie. I mean, Adventurer you can kind of see as Bruce Wayne or Batman himself, and Blackberry would obviously be the Alfred. Just like how Adventurer doesn't seem to get through many of his missions these days without the help of Blackberry rescuing him, so too would Bruce Wayne not be able to pull off being Batman if it weren't for Alfred there. I mean, Alfred keeps him, well, not just sane-wise, but, you know, takes care of all the Bruce Wayne stuff. You know, he is a butler still. And speaking of being a butler, the treasures that I've given Blackberry for this trial run are things that, again, I feel fit her aesthetically. I gave her the milk snack treasure because she would probably be giving snacks to guests of the Honored Mansion or, you know, for Adventurer himself. The red luxury carpet, because she probably spends a lot of time cleaning that, since a lot of filthy boots probably come through there. And the Mirror of Malice. Not really the malice part per se fits her, at least in my opinion, but I feel like, again, she is kind of this macabre, reserved, almost stoic kind of personality. And again, being a butler, she probably does, you know, clean mirrors, and that probably gets annoying for her. I probably should stop calling her butler. She's a maid. Or, actually, I don't know. Are maids and butlers, like, the same thing, just gender-swapped versions, like actor and actress? Or are they actually slightly different things? Like, can you have a female butler or a male maid? A male maid. Sounds a lot like mermaid. But, anyways, I'll probably look that up later. That's the good thing about today, right? You can Google just about anything you want. Because I'm trying to think about what it was like before the internet. I mean, I'm not that old, but I'm also not that young. But at the same time, I got the internet at a really late age, so I was really late to the internet game. But even still, it's hard to imagine going back to a time before that. Chili pepper cookies dough contained much more chili pepper than was allowed by the law. This is probably why she doesn't care much about rules. Chili pepper is a notorious treasure hunter. She never misses a chance to snatch everything valuable she can get her hands on, leaving only chaos and havoc behind. The cookies know better than to cross her path, and so should you. Good news, you can easily identify this path by a trail of fiery red chili sauce. Okay, so this description is fun and all, but what's exactly going on here? Because she was an illegally made cookie, she disobeys rules herself? Does this imply that cookies lack free will? Also, who made this law? Other cookies? The ancient wizards? The dragon? Explain yourself, Chili Pepper. Regardless, like Adventurer, Chili Pepper too is a treasure hunter. I imagine the two might be rivals of some sort, and you can guess this is why I included her in the same video as Adventurer Cookie. Now, going back to the idea of Chili Pepper causing me to ask questions about how the cookie world works, let's take a quick look at her pet, the Bad Pepper. Wanna make some mayhem? I'm your man. Or Pepper, rather. Chili Pepper Cookie has drawn only one eye for Bad Pepper, because that's how a true bandit should look like. Although he clearly pops both eyes out when he sees the cookie police. So many questions here. Okay, so is Bad Pepper an actual sentient pepper creature? Or is he kind of like an imaginary friend sort of thing? I mean, she has drawn eyes on him, but he apparently has both eyes? And he speaks, or does he? I mean, could that just be like a flavor text of her imagining that's what he says? Because again, he's like an imaginary friend. Ah, jeez. Oh well. All I know is that the questions don't end when we involve the final cook of today's video. There's also a neat interaction when you use Chili Pepper Cookie in a particular stage of Breakout Episode 1, The Sands of Yogurka. But we'll save that for that video. The final cookie for today is one of the first cookies that I maxed out, red pepper. Whole chunks of spicy peppers were added to the dough to make red pepper cookie. His biggest desire is to become the toughest Muay Thai fighter in the world. To do so, Red Pepper can spend days and nights training in the most unthinkable conditions. He even refused to leave the oven to make his body hard as stone. He's now got quite a tan, which goes perfectly with his fiery charisma. Red Pepper Cookie considers his hairstyle a symbol of his strong will and dedication, so he has no plans to change it. As some of you may know, I'm a sucker for monks and martial artists of any kind. Thus, I was quickly drawn to Red Pepper when I first started playing the game. Subsequent monkish cookies have been released, whom I enjoy a bit more design-wise, and we'll cover them eventually. But still, I do like Red Pepper. He's focused on obstacle destruction, and that's where he's going to be scoring the most of his points. Good thing Red Pepper has a good kit for obstacle destruction. Between his own innate abilities and the abilities of his pet, the Paprika Punching Bag, he has a lot of ways to keep obstacles off of him. So his own ability allows him to enter some sort of fiery aura mode, kind of almost like a Super Saiyan, where he's able to be indestructible for a brief period of time, and even if his energy is completely zeroed out, while he's in this mode, he's still able to keep going. After you factor in his pet, who is able to produce giant jellies that also restore a bit of health, you've got one cookie who is constantly able to destroy obstacles. The treasures that I've given Red Pepper today are things that help him move fast and hit hard. So, again, things that a monk would use. I've given him the Red Hot Turbo Engine because, well, Red Pepper is a spicy pepper. The Almond Hammer of Destruction or something like that. I forget the full name, but it's a simple common treasure, but it increases the amount of points you get for obstacle destruction. And the final treasure is the Scroll of Guidance. Because, being a monk, he has incredible willpower and great discipline. So I figured it would make sense that he would follow the instructions given on this particular scroll. I know I've talked about this a lot in previous videos, but I really mean it. I love the backgrounds to a lot of the areas in Cookie Run. Like, look at the amount of detail that's in the background of this, tribe area? I forget what this is called. It's like... it's not the Pinata Candy Kingdom. It's something else. I think it's like a pineapple tribe or something like that. But, I don't know, I really like this kind of South American, maybe even African tribal aesthetic. Like, it's just, it's a really neat setting, especially when you factor in, like, adventurers and, you know, Indiana Jones, curses, temples, dungeon explorations, that kind of stuff. Oh yes, I forgot to mention, Red Pepper's magic candy. It allows him to revive upon death. So it's kind of a simple magic candy, really, but it's pretty handy. It increases the amount of time that you have to activate abilities, collect jellies. Obviously, the longer you run, the better it is, so that's really nice. And it fits aesthetically. You know, he has the willpower to keep going even after his body is telling him that it's shutting down. But, you know, it's like they say, mind over matter. I also find his trial to be quite fun. It's fast-paced and filled with lots of action. Red Pepper and his sister Chili have extra animations for whenever they destroy obstacles. That's a neat detail. Also, yes, Red Pepper and Chili Pepper are siblings. So, how do cookie families work? I thought all cookies were made or baked or crafted, but... can cookies reproduce? Jeez, I don't even want to think about that. Why does the Pepper family of cookies bring up so many questions? Anyways, I wanted to talk to you all about this LP. I've done Cookie Run videos with both live and post commentary, but which do you prefer? Usually, I prefer live commentary for LPs, but I've found that post seems to work better with this sort of game. So I'll probably be sticking to post commentary for all future Cookie Run videos. But what do you all think? Please let me know in the comments below. Besides that, I want you all to have a blessed day.